There are two different ways to run batch-wise adsorption in a column, and both can be called chromatography: peak separation or column saturation. We will focus on the variant where you partially saturate the column. A feed with a constant concentration, Z0, of the adsorbate is led into a fresh or regenerated column. Initially, the concentration in the outlet is zero, but after a while, the concentration increases, and when the column has reached saturation, the concentration in the outlet is the same as the concentration in the inlet. The graph showing how the concentration in the outlet varies with time is called the breakthrough curve. Before we analyze how the breakthrough curve can be interpreted, let us ask ourselves what to adsorb in the column. If we have a feed rich in our valuable product, but with small amounts of contaminants, we want to adsorb the contaminants and let the product go straight through. After the column has been saturated, it needs to be regenerated before being used again. If we, on the other hand, have a feed with low concentration of our valuable product, we want to adsorb the product and let contaminants and the bulk of the solvent go straight through. We will then first saturate our column with our product. We call this loading the column. And to increase the purity of the product, we then wash the column before we elute the product from the column. The column then needs to be regenerated before being used again. There are also cases where we have more than one product in the feed. If the products are different enough from each other, we might find an adsorbent that adsorbs one but not the other. If the difference in residence time for the products is large enough, we might then load, wash, elute, and regenerate. Otherwise, it's likely a better option to use peak separation, as is often done in analytical chromatography. In saturating the column, what we would like to see is a so-called constant pattern to develop. If we look at the concentration profile inside the column, well, we start with a column with no adsorbate in it, so zero concentration. Our adsorbate comes in from the left in this figure, and as it travels through the column, the shape of the concentration profile changes initially, but after a while it remains the same shape. We have developed a constant pattern. In the outlet, we see over time a mirror image of the concentration profile in the column. Thus, the profile initially changes, and then a constant pattern develops, and we get an S-shaped breakthrough curve. The initial broadening of the profile is due to dispersion and diffusion. If the adsorption isotherm is favorable, the low concentration part of the profile will be slowed down compared to the rest of the profile, which counteracts the broadening. We will come back to this so-called self-sharpening of the concentration profile in the video on upscaling. The example breakthrough curve showed here was symmetrical, but that is not always the case. So why is the breakthrough curve sometimes asymmetric? Well, there might be mass transfer resistance in the column, meaning that the adsorbate needs to diffuse through a stagnant layer, for example, inside the porous material, before being actually adsorbed. Another reason might be due to dispersion and diffusion changing over time, for example, due to changes in temperature. And a third reason is that the adsorption process in itself might be too slow.